Sports. It's in the game.
Foot on the gas, I will not crash. They will not stop me. Tenfold, copy, end zone. Watch me, celebrate, I'm cocky. I do my damn.
Hey, how fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. On my grind now, game on, took a loss but I stay strong, Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off, gotta go hard, I can never play soft, giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon, and I gotta win no matter what, like, fourth down, Hail Mary, no punch, like, every time I touch down, I gotta stunt, Randy Moss, yeah, my numbers going up, all these trophies, what do I need any more for, check the stats up, you can check the scoreboard, check the stats, J. Critch, I'm the QB, ran it up and then I went and got a new freeze. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings.
Start the regular season by selecting your season goal. Meeting your season goal comes with higher rewards, but also higher risk.
I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. If you ain't a winner, then don't come round. On my way to another city, it's a touchdown. Under late, yeah, I gotta get it in a rush now. Let them hate, try to knock me down, but we got up now. Say that you ballin', keep it real though. Ay, why I never saw you in the field though? Ay, I make it look easy, it's a field goal. I've been grindin' for a minute and I'm still going. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off.
Guys, last time we were out here, coaching staff didn't like what we saw. You all know it wasn't good enough. So let's make up for that today and have a great one. I know you got it in you. So let me see that greatness come out on the field, all right? Let's do it.
Let's go now, let's go now, let's go now. 15 Lonnie, 15 Lonnie. Set, go! Set, ready. 90, Wolf. Ready, ready!
Cook it up, gourmet.
Ready, ready, Super Saiyan, go Lobo.
Anything I ever do is top rank.
Hey, you know what, men? That was pretty dang good. And you know what's really scary? It gets me even more excited. We're only scratching the surface of our potential. This team has so much talent. So just keep pushing, and we're gonna get to that next level.
I go Super Saiyan, go tank. Anything I ever do.
is top rank.
Designer sneakers hurt my feet now. Every beat is getting beat down. Couldn't eat, well, watch I eat now. Like, how you getting paid to freestyle? Different cities every week now. Every woman is a now. What state prop you looking bleak now? I was home to sleep designing sheets now. 30 different missions. When I speak, they listen. Couldn't find the social fishing. Who the crew? It wasn't you. I know it's true, cause you look like the opposition. Run it up, greatest ever sums it up. I ain't have a lot when I was coming up. Kinda made my stomach turn when I brung it up.
Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank.
It's lonely on top of the throne. I ain't a king of the pawn. Hop on a jet, cross the globe. I guess the world is my home, and there's so many miracles bird in my dome. And like turbulent air, I'm switching these flows. If you look at my neck, boy, I'm letting it snow. I'm sturdy as hell, it's a vessel alone. They showing me love in my city. Gangs ain't hippies. Women like thinking know what I'm about. I'm not. The stereotypes, they do not fit me. I'm bigger than life. Give everyone jobs. I'm not a guard, go hop with a squad. I'm playing my part, but I'm LeBron. Wings of the team, I feel Jackson and hard. The homie calling from a cell. A couple of homies be making it. I just want all of them dudes to do well. Not worry about taking a couple of L's. Don't sin for me, just win for me. Don't kill for me, just live for me. Keep it real for me. We eat together, leave the bill for me. Like,
hand on my heart. I give it all I got. Walk the walk inside the tar. Take a higher, that's a go.
The Zach Taylor era begins in Cincinnati. It's the coach. This is week one of the NFL on EA Sports. Coming up, the Bengals have a new man calling the shots. Zach Taylor, the second youngest coach in the entire league, as they head to Seattle to take on the oldest coach in the league, Pete Carroll of the Seattle Seahawks. I'll be back at halftime with a look at the games in progress. But first, let's get up to Seattle. Standing by are the guys in the booth, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Coach, it is a sound like no other when they raise that 12th man flag here in Seattle. We just heard it, and that means it's time for football at CenturyLink Field. This crowd, as we've come to expect in recent years, as loud as any in the NFL, and they get even louder when their Seahawks are introduced. We're ready for football as the Seahawks get set to do battle with the Cincinnati Bengals. So happy to be with you, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis, and we thought it would never get here, but here we are back together. It's opening weekend of the 100th season in the NFL.
So much football to talk about. That's our main focus. But how about how much happened in the offseason? Rules changes, overtime rules were discussed in a big way, some superstars changed addresses. There's a whole lot to talk about in the NFL in addition to this game we're getting ready to watch.
Here's Randy Bullock now to put toe to leather, and off we go from Seattle. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Seahawks offense here set to take over with Russell Wilson leading the way. Wilson, a Pro Bowler five times in his seven NFL seasons, including last year, when he threw for a career-high 35 touchdowns to just seven interceptions. This is Chris Carson, 1,000-yard rusher a year ago. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down. And we take a look at the offense for the Seahawks.
And last night, we were discussing some of the changes they've made offensively during the offseason, and we know it helps for them to have the first game at home. Hopefully this crowd, which we saw coming in, they've been here for a while, ready to go. You and I should have joined the tailgates, that's for sure. They're going to give them plenty of encouragement. They'll try and ride that wave and get their first victory of the year.
Here's Carson. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first. And the Bengals starting defensive unit now.
Strong safety Sean Williams really bounced back from injuries in previous seasons to post one of the best years of his NFL career. 5 interceptions in 2018, led the league in interception return yards, provides great veteran leadership, and some real thump coming from his spot in the secondary.
And they'll look to avoid an early three and out here on third and four. From the shotgun, Wilson. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
Gotta love the catch. I think you gotta love the gloves as well.
Yeah, these one-handed catches, that was great, and they're fun. They've become a little more ho-hum, aren't they?
Yeah, they really are. And I know that it sounds like we're taking credit away from the guys, and we don't mean that at all. They really work hard on this one-handed catch thing, but I think the gloves have to be helping in a big way.
Fourth down, and out is the all-pro punter from a year ago, Michael Dixon, to punt for Seattle. He'll kick it away after a three and out on the opening drive of the game. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the Bengals will take over here first and 10. So here are the Bengals under first-year head coach Zach Taylor. And they will be led out by their 6'4 quarterback.
And I liked what his head coach told us about him this week, that no matter what happens, whether he throws 7 interceptions or 7 touchdown passes, he's the same assertive leader in the huddle on each and every play. He can throw the 7 interceptions, just blame the football, blame anything else, and still carry himself like he is the man.
It's like you, assertive in our production meetings.
Well, especially when we're talking about ordering dinner, ordering some
snacks.
I was
just going to say.
That's where I go.
And they work this well upfield across the 45. That's good for 28 yards. And a nice start there to the aerial attack to pick up the first.
And I think preseason is officially over now. Getting into the groove of the regular season, that's a great way to get started. First drive of the season, what a nice completion.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. From the gun, Steele. Got his man, it's Eifert. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, from their point of view, this game could not be starting out much better, could it? Force a punt on defense, and now they're moving it crisply on offense.
Crisply, I like that. Yeah, moving it very, very well. Looks like the defense on their heels a little bit. You put a score in here, long way to go, but you're right, that's a heck of a start.
Yeah, and I think this is where the play caller is looking at his play sheet and saying, grab that dagger play, grab that play and just finish them off right now, because I think they'd love to gain that big advantage early.
Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and 9. And a look now at the Cincinnati offense.
Obviously a tough test for this offense right out of the gate. Road game in game 1 of the new year. Conventional wisdom says, go slow, take care of the football. I think in this case, attack early and get the home team back on their heels.
They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9. Second and 9 now. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. 16 yards, a first down. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far.
Mike 54. Watch the slap. Watch the slap.
Mixon with a first down carry. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. A 10-yard touchdown run as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you've got to see a fist pump on the sideline from the head coach, don't you? Because he's turning to his bench, and he's telling his team, this is how we prepare. Force the punt, go downfield and score. I told you guys, it's just like a boxer in the gym preparing for the fight. Now we get to turn it all loose.
On for the point after is Randy Bullock. And he's got it to make it 7-0 Bengals. A drive that time of 6 plays, and it all culminated in the touchdown run coming from Joe Mixon. This defense already looking at a deficit on the scoreboard, but now what can they design here to disrupt this third down play?
Let's go, let's go, let's go! 60, Pittsburgh! We take
the win! On third down, Steele. He's got his man here, it's Green. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 23. Green last year had the lowest numbers of his career output-wise, 694 yards, 6 touchdowns, but of course there was a reason for that. He was battling a toe injury the second half of the season, and boy, did the Bengals miss his presence. They limped to the finish line, losing 7 of their last 8. They are happy to have him back and healthy. First and 10, Steele. He gets this one to Boyd. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. That throw good for 4. It's second down. 7th round pick. He made it through training camp. Now he's getting some reps.
And that's all you want, an opportunity. 7th round pick. I haven't met a 7th round pick yet that didn't play really, really hard because they're ticked off they didn't go in the first 6 rounds. All you want is that chance, and once they get it, many times they turned out to be great players.
They added a lot of talent to a roster that really needed an infusion of youth. They got a very good infusion of youth.
And they didn't really reach to get anyone as well. They stuck to their draft philosophy, got the best players they could at the time they were drafting, and inserted them into their lineup.
And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. That'll set them back with a loss of 3 on the play. And they're going to have a 3rd down.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on 3rd down. Operating from the gun, Steele, and Eifert has it. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. From 21 yards away, and the Bengals, they widen their lead.
An excellent, long, sustained offensive drive. And now they can look across the field and see a defense that looks a little bit beaten down. Right now, as an offensive coordinator, you're thinking to yourself, can I dial up the knockout punch?
Here's Bullock now for the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. Makes the score So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it ends with a Bengals score. Second quarter, this defense looking for a big third down stop here. They're already down on the scoreboard, just trying to get the ball back to their offense. To throw on third down. Steal, flushed out right. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. That's not one that he's going to want to remember, but he had to get it out of the way at some point, his first career interception.
And if he's the guy that they think he is, he's not laughing it off, but he's also not going to let it affect him as the game proceeds. He's going to go back out there, still be the same confident kid, the reason that they drafted him, and go out and play.
A reminder, coming up later tonight, the Patriots unfurl their six banners. They play host to their rival Steelers. And then on Monday night, it's the one weekend of the year where you get... So not much left here before we reach halftime as the offense is out there now hoping to put together a scoring drive before they head to the locker room. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. Give credit to KJ Wright. He was disrupting defensively. Well, the Bengals and Seahawks meeting here in week one, and this is a combination that we haven't seen that often on the turf. If you look back to when the franchises began facing each other all the way back in 1977, but since then, just 20 meetings between the two teams, and the Bengals have won 11 of them, including the last meeting back in October of 2015. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down.
I'm coming after you.
From the gun, steal. And that will be incomplete. Give credit to KJ Wright. He was disrupting defensively.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
So on fourth down, here's Matt Darr to kick it away. Back deep for the Seahawks, Tyler Lockett. And the fair catch is made at about the 27-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. Tyler Lockett trotting onto the field, getting set for this next drive. They've got to be thinking, how can we get him a little bit... Coming up here, this defense looking for a third down stop in the second quarter. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. And that's the risk of the long field goal miss here at this stage of the second quarter. You give up great field position.
And that gives them one more opportunity to make something happen, and something big. And we've seen crazy stuff happen at the end of it.
Set, ready, 90, 4, 15. You're gonna see me in your nightmare, son. H3,
chopper, chopper. Leo, 36, 36.
On first down, Nixon. And this will go as a short gain on what will be the final act of this first half. So we are at halftime here in the opener of the 2019 regular season. As we send you cross country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome back to football, everybody. We've got a full slate of 16 games here to start the new season. So let's take our first trip around the NFL. We'll get started down at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami, where it was the visiting Ravens who were able to come in and take this one on the road. A 31-point win, 38-7, the final. Next, we'll stay right here in the Sunshine State and head up to Tampa to check on the Bucs. And they trail in that one as it's the visiting 49ers who are out in front. Emmanuel Sanders, a touchdown reception. Finally, we head to the shores of Lake Erie. See what's going on with the Cleveland Browns. And they were winners in that one as they defeat the visiting Tennessee Titans. Baker Mayfield, two touchdown passes as his guys are able to get the victory in their season opener. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back and forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Bengal offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. It was Trey Flowers that time who got a hand in and broke it up. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Throwing again. Steele. Going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. To the left side here for Eifert. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. They'll get 14 on that one. Good for a Bengal first down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. This quarterback now 12 of 17 through the air as he leads his guys up on first down. Now Joe Mixon. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Now, after that last play, there's a Bengal down on the field. Huh, hate to see this. Week one of the season. We'll be back. So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Check 13, check 13. Watch the end. Ready. Now a first carry for Giovanni Bernard. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
It inside the 10 to the 9.
Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Partner, they weren't quite in the red zone, but things are starting to get condensed on the field. Throwing the corner route there, really nice play because it gives them a little bit of room to complete it.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal.
Slam. Watch twist. Watch hopper. Chopper. Ready, go.
They'll give it to Mixon. Only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Here's second and 8. Looking for Boyd, and he's got him. Touchdown, Bengals. 8 yards on the touchdown pass. And the Bengals, they widen their lead.
There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron. Had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes...
you throw, what, a touchdown strike?
There you go. That's my man, in concert.
Now Bullock to add the extra point. It's good, and it's 21-10. So a nice drive put together there. They go 75 yards in 9 plays. And it's finished off with a Cincinnati touchdown. This offense has marched the ball down the field nicely. In good position, can they finish the drive off? First and 10 in the red zone. They'll run on first down. Mixon. He takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of 3.
Part of a middle linebacker's job is being able to take on blocks and then go make plays. But the best ones, they have those big guys in front of them playing defensive line to hold blockers off of them and allow them to flow sideline to sideline and make the big hits.
Back now in Seattle, Washington. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Looking to throw on second down. Steele. Got an open man. That's C.J. Uzama. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
And, partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Now the Bengals on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This is 3rd and 4. Operating from the gun. Steal. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, holding on to the lead at this stage in the second half, those are the types of plays you really want to try. Stay away from.
And when you're
what? Green 80.
51. Quarterback, don't get nervous now.
Green 80.
After the interception, here's Wilson. They'll run the screen with Carson. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up 2nd down. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on 1st down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're either throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open.
So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a 2nd and long. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and they'll be facing a 3rd and 12. On 3rd down, Wilson. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
This is taken around the 12. Not a big deal on that one, just your everyday 67-yard punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And out now, here come the Bengals. And they had a nice little drive going last time. Threw the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got 3 on the board for sure. And to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah. Will they make up for it? They'll begin here with Bernard. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 12-yard line. It's a loss of 8 there on the 1st down play. To throw on 2nd down. Steal. Got a man open. It's Ross. That catch good for only 1 yard, and it'll be 3rd down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Now a pass hauled in downfield. How about 25 yards on 3rd down? They'll take it. Big hookup there. Forced to throw it on 3rd down. The connection's going to keep the drive alive and also keep the clock moving.
Yeah, and from a defensive perspective, didn't get a sack, didn't knock the ball free, didn't break up the pass, the clock keeps running on you, you're in a dire situation now.
Some good games around the league here early in week one, and this one shaping up to be as good as any of them as we come up on a first and 10. Now Bernard, and he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. It was Jaron Reed who got him down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take. It's a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a third and 11 situation.
And this is why the head coach gets paid the big bucks. Look at where they are in this situation, partner. Do you throw the ball here in a long distance situation? Do you run it again and trust your defense and make sure you take care of the ball and punt it away? What kind of options do you have here? And what do you trust more on your team?
Yeah, they may have just pushed him back into that throwing situation. We'll see. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Back to throw. Steal. And able to find Green. 18 yards on that one, and the Bengals are moving. First down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. Well, this is how you shake the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4 for 4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when who told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row, I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football.
And here's a throw taken in by Boyd. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 31-yard line. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Throwing on first down. Steele. He completes it to Boyd. And now right out of the 2 minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with 1:56 to go. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down.
Watch the safety creep. You're out.
On the toss, Bernard. They'll get 14 on that one. Good for a Bengal first down.
Coming in, he really liked his chance of having a big year based on a terrific offseason. And runs like that on opening weekend show that he's right.
His way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Now the Seahawks call the second of their 3 timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. This, in all probability, another run here on 2nd and 8. Now a toss play to Bernard. Oh no, he lost the football. And the Seahawks have picked it up.
And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
All I know, partners, that with every play call that came in, there was a little discussion about, hey, we can seal this bad boy. We can really put ourselves in a great spot to take total control. And yet, they find a way to cough it up.
Yeah, the two-score game opportunity eludes them, and now a chance for the other side to come back here.
Yeah, that means defense has to go out there and make some plays themselves. So we call sudden change. Let's see if the defense is mentally ready to take care of it.
It's caught. Lockett. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. A good pickup there at 22. Obviously a big first down right there.
Yeah, they still got to hustle. They got to get up to the line of scrimmage and get set. But I don't think necessarily you need to spike it. But they've got to continue to move quickly.
Line of scrimmage again, the 37, as they line up second and 10. He's back to throw. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. And the Bengals grab it.
Well, that simply is a missed opportunity. They're in position. If they take the ball downfield and score, they've got a chance to win the game. Instead, they cough it up. I don't think next week at practice is going to be a whole lot of fun for him.
On the other side, no bigger time to force a turnover when you've got that small lead.
Yeah, and when you look at it from the offense's perspective, taking care of the ball, so important. I know they're going to have all kind of ball security drills in practice all next week.
The Bengal offense now gets set to head back out onto the field. And this one all over. We drop you back into the action here. Ball in the red zone. Offense has it with a first down.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. 60, Pittsburgh.
Following the fumble recovery, steal. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It's way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. They'll run it here with Brown. And they'll get this down to the 10. Now the Seahawks forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll get it with just a shade under a minute to go in the game. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Now it looks like he'll throw here. That's complete right around the 8. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. He'll get only 2 there and it's second and goal.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Here's second and goal, operating from the 8-yard line. Now a give, right side, Bernard. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a couple yards there, and that's going to set up a long third and goal. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop. Ball right around the 5 here brings up third.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
So this one in the win column now for the Cincinnati Bengals. And partner, I must say, good to see you again. Been too long. And it's good to have football back, isn't it?
D,
Didn't you see me in preseason? Weren't we together in preseason?
Yeah, but preseason, you know, it's preseason. This is week one.
Oh, you're trying to say real football.
Yeah, real football.
Not preseason football, yeah. Where we shake down the rosters and figure out who's going to play, and maybe the starters don't play as much. Now it's the frontline guys from the first whistle.
Yeah, I tuned you out in the preseason, and now I'm listening to you. So for the Bengals, it wasn't always pretty, but they do eke out the week one victory here by a field goal. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for Seattle, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll try to rebound next week as they head to Heinz Field to take on the Steelers. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden.